Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Soumya Swaminathan, the Deputy Director General for Programs at the WHO. Greetings from Geneva. At WHO, we are so pleased to be working with you all to improve the quality of care in mental health and social services and to ensure that people with mental health conditions are able to exercise their human rights. This is so important all around the world. Many people who have mental health conditions face terrible challenges. Stigma, for example, that sets them apart and forces them into isolation, banished to the margins of society, unable to work or study, in some cases even to feed and clothe themselves, or confinement in an institution where they are caged or shackled, over-medicated, deprived of clothing, decent bedding, clean water, or proper toilet facilities. Many countries even prohibit people from voting, from marrying or having children. And many people are denied the opportunity to make decisions about even some of the most basic aspects of their lives. It's hard to imagine what that feels like, how overwhelmingly disempowered, rejected and lonely that would make one. And that's why the WHO's Quality Rights Initiative focuses on changing attitudes to mental health, both within society as a whole and also, very importantly, among the health community itself. It's why we strive to ensure that services are of good quality, respecting people's rights and promoting holistic care that focuses on the individual and on helping them recover. One way we do this is through an online e-training program, which has already produced some quite dramatic improvements. We have seen health professionals who have done the training express regret for the way they have treated people in the past and tell us that how they feel better able to support people after having taken this course. Family members of patients with mental health conditions have acquired new ideas and techniques for supporting their relatives and respecting their rights, choices, and preferences. And most important of all, people who have experienced mental health issues say that they feel validated and empowered to assert their rights. So on behalf of WHO, I wish to congratulate the government of Ghana and its civil society partners and wish you all the very best as you move ahead to implement this initiative throughout the country. You're one of the few countries to have decided to take this countrywide, and we're very grateful for that, and we look forward to hearing from you your feedback and suggestions for further improvement. This is a great way to start the new year, and I wish you all the very best. Thank you.